Hello and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Manu.
And I'm Paul.
In this video, we'll talk through the key roles that should be involved in developing a Power BI Adoption strategy for your organization. The most influential role for driving a data-driven culture is that of a corporate sponsor. If the leaders of the organization are committed to empowering people in the organization with data and are ready to invest in this program, then it's an excellent starting position because it means that you can straight away focus on what and how rather than having to convince people about the why. Corporate sponsors can also help with providing funding for the program, user training, and Power BI licenses. They can help in identifying the business areas which will deliver maximum value to the organization by being data-driven, and also have an authority to prioritize and approve projects. A Power BI champion is someone who has very deep understanding of self-service BI. This could be someone from Microsoft, a Microsoft partner firm, or someone from within the customer organization. It would be ideal if they have a very good understanding of Power BI as well. Although, if they are willing enough and have the right resources, they can develop that knowledge along the way. They are the evangelists who inspire people to become data-driven, and then help the organization or the team on their journey towards a data-driven culture. They typically work closely with the corporate sponsor to strategically deploy Power BI across the organization or their team. Data is almost certainly the most valuable asset and differentiator that organizations have in today's digital world. So it is extremely important to ensure that the data is secured in the best possible way. And data policy enforcement is in place to make sure that data is used in accordance with the internal and external compliance regulations. Data or information security managers play a huge role in defining the organizational policies around data residence, auditing, and security. Most organizations either have someone in that exact role or have someone who's responsible for this area, and they play a very vital role in a self-service BI environment. The data architect is responsible for technical implementation of the business requirements while ensuring that the governance and security requirements of the organization are met. Given that the Power BI service is hosted in the cloud, they should have an understanding of on-premises and cloud technologies. This role is typically performed by a technical consultant who could be from Microsoft or a partner organization. However, some organizations do have these skills in-house. The key characteristic of the data steward role is their business understanding of the data. They help improve the quality of the data, accurately define data fields and metrics, maintain business metadata in a data catalog, and mash up data from various sources to surface new augmented views of existing data. Depending on the size of the organization, you may or may not have people in this role. Some organizations have a reporting team that develops data models and reports for various teams, including the execs. In other organizations, business analysts play a part of this role because they have a very good understanding of the business data and act as the interface between business users and the technical teams.
Traditionally, BI development teams develop end-to-end BI solutions. In a self-service environment, they can be enablers for the business by provisioning high-quality data for self-service consumption. They can also develop new corporate BI solutions, enhance existing solutions, and automate the release management process for corporate BI. Power BI Administrator is a new role or responsibility. The Power BI service has a lot of administration capabilities like tenant level settings, usage reporting, etc. And this capability is being enhanced with new releases of Power BI. The intention is to make this a one-stop shop for all Power BI administration requirements. The administrator will play a major role at the time of setup by working with various teams on assessing the suitability of the tenant settings to their organization's needs. The admin will need to work with the Office 365 and Azure admins, as some of the Power BI capabilities like auditing are available via the Office 365 Admin Center. And some of the Azure Active Directory configuration may need involvement from the Azure admin. They're also responsible for monitoring the service and managing on-premises gateways. Power BI requires a service delivery manager to help with the support of the tool, and their support team will work with Power BI administrators and Microsoft support teams to monitor and resolve any issues within the service within specified SLAs. They provide day-to-day support for users, for example, granting access to apps that deliver corporate BI, or creating new connections on Power BI gateways. They can also act as part-time development resources and help with minor enhancements of corporate and IT-managed BI solutions, and also manage the release of code changes into production workspaces. Business Support Specialist is another new role that's extremely valuable in self-service environments and can be outsourced to a partner firm. The intention is to have advanced technical support available for business users when they get stuck while writing a complex calculation or creating visualizations. This team can also develop reusable templates for business users to accelerate their journey of developing Power BI solutions. Now we've taken you through the different roles, it's important to assign people in your organization to fulfill them. This may be one or more individuals, and their responsibility is to attend the appropriate workshops and have an input into process or configuration decisions relevant to their role. We've included a link to the slides used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment. See you in the next one.